And your current collection agency is no help.
Blog Tired
of hearing
radio.
The check in the mail? Write down the phone number for McCabe Smith Reynolds & Associates. 800-699-DEBT. That's 800-699-DEBT. McCabe Smith Reynolds & Associates is a South Florida-based professional collections firm, and they can help you to collect the money that's owed to your company. They work on a contingency basis, so if they don't collect, you pay absolutely nothing. Collections on bad checks, delinquent accounts, judgments, and all types of overdue receivables. They can even handle background checks, credit reporting to all three credit bureaus, and they provide worldwide attorney services. McCabe Smith & Reynolds will work just like a seamless extension of your own company, providing written and verbal verification of all collection accounts, timely status reports, and litigation support. Bottom line, McCabe Smith & Reynolds gets results. Get your cash flow going in the right direction. Go with the firm that Bill Lewis uses, McCabe Smith Reynolds & Associates. Offices conveniently located in Pompano Beach. Call 800-699-DEBT. That's 800-699-DEBT. Or go online to msrcollections.com.
Here's hoping you're healthy and wealthy. South Florida's Health and Wealth Radio Network. AM 1470, WWNN, Pompano Beach.
Silence calms the mind and rejuvenates the body. Godpillow has been inspiring daily devotions for over 11 years. God pillows are custom made with love and intention. We encourage you to become part of our community. Come visit God Pillow on the World Wide Web at GodPillow.com. Attention, the 4th annual 12-step music fest is coming November 3rd through the 6th in Sugarloaf Key, Florida. 4 days of music and fun with 12 musical acts along with the Rockers in Recovery Supergroup featuring Ricky Bird, guitarist formerly of Joan Jett and the Blackhearts, Liberty DeVito, formerly of Billy Joel, Woody Geisman of the Del Fuegos, Jason Sultan of Todd Rundgren and Utopia, Christine Ullman of the Saturday Night Live Band, and four more to be announced by September. Find out more about this sober Woodstock in Sugarloaf Key by joining rockersinrecovery.com or by calling 877-799-8773. Free concert. Rockers in Recovery Memorial Day Weekend Concert, May 28th from 1:30 to 6:30 p.m. featuring Ricky Bird, guitarist of the NYC Hit Squad and formerly of Joan Jett and the Blackhearts, along with Kasem Sultan, bassist of Todd Rundgren and Utopia, Mick Jagger, and Celine Dion. Plus, three other great bands, Johnny B and the Road Dogs, Keep Coming Back Band, and Rhetoric. Come out and join us at the First Step Sober House Memorial Day Free Concert at 450 Southwest 2nd Street, Pompano Beach. To find out more, go to rockersinrecovery.com or call 877-799-8773.
In the fast-paced world we live in, it's hard to find a company that has an impeccable reputation based on professional skill and knowledge, coupled with a strong work ethic, honesty, and integrity. Welcome to the world of Canatelli Builders Incorporated. Specialists in custom residential and commercial construction for three generations, CBI finishes the job as agreed and on time. Browse our website at www.canatellibuilders.com, read the testimonials, then call us at 954-977-2775 and let us add your name to our list of satisfied customers. While at the site, be sure to follow the link for complete information about Chinese drywall and what it may mean to you. Integrity, ethics, honesty, knowledge, performance, service, experience, Canatelli Builders. 954-277-2775. Canatelli Builders, the official contractor for the Florida Panthers.
Did
we say?
I can just see it now. You know, the natives are going to kill me. You know,
the hood.
Drive-bys for
the
next
hood.
One.
The hood. It's all good though.
Yeah.
We're all going to be right up there at 450 Southwest 2nd Street, right in the middle of it all.
Rocking in the ghetto.
Rocking in the ghetto.
Yeah.
We're going to have some fun. Hey, listen, there's a guy coming that's going to be with Rhetoric that is actually going to not only play rap behind some, he's going to actually be singing rap behind them playing their music, which is actually going to be pretty interesting. We're looking forward to this whole thing, man. So here, Toronto Live just called me yesterday. They're coming in from Tampa.
There.
Were you?
Yeah, I was out there this weekend in the Tampa area.
I thought it was
softball tournament, which we are champions again.
Okay, I was wrong, folks. I said he was in Winter Haven, and I was hoping that you were three points down is actually what I said. If he doesn't make it, I hope he's 3 points down. That's what I said.
I put my toes in the sand and Jeff Tiva, too. It's really nice.
Really?
Yeah.
You look tan, bro. You look tan. I mean, you've been going out on the boat. What's going on with you?
Well,
you just look too healthy.
It's about the gifts we get when we do the right thing for a period of time. I was 2 weeks down in the Virgin Islands in the island. It was nice.
And how was that?
Visual.
Really?
Visual.
And what else was going on down there? And anything good? Anything good?
Well, you know.
Yeah?
Nighttime was great.
Nighttime was great?
Yes, it was. So it was in the afternoon and the morning.
Well, hey, listen, you know, in recovery, we get to go on vacations. We get to do these things. We get to have a lot of fun. And, I mean, you know, what kind of fun did you have?
I can't talk about it on the radio.
No.
Yeah.
Well, it's not visual.
But, you know,
it's not visual.
We're on a 10-second delay, right?
Just keep pushing that 10-second delay button for like 20 minutes. Just 20 minutes. That's all we need.
It's a passion for me. It really is. And, you know, when you're sailing and you have the islands all around, you really get to see the grandeur of God's work is what it really is. And so I always take a spiritual point of view right up to the point the drunks show up.
Ooh.
And then I get relegated as a dinghy captain because I have to drive them all around. They're like, blah, 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 you know, and they're like, oh, yeah, Chris will take them. Nice.
Well, it's actually kind of fun. You know?
So I dropped them offshore one day and said, bye.
Right.
<Come back.
laughs> Really?
Yes, I did.
Oh, that's horrible.
So my captainship ended fast.
I'm sure.
Yeah.
You didn't ask you again.
No.
Well, that's the way to get out of it.
That's how I did it.
Absolutely. You know, we're looking for a special segment for this particular hour, and when we find it, I'll be the first one to let you guys know. You know, every great conspiracy has been built on Facebook. And
I knew you were going to bring it up, innit?
Every great conspiracy. So you can start some real crap on Facebook. Throw anything you want up, literally within a half a day, not only has it changed, I mean, like, listen, you know, little Sally ran across the bridge. 45 people later is little Sally ran across the bridge and got pregnant. Little Sally ran across the bridge and was impregnated by an alien. I mean, it just goes on and on and on.
Are you talking about my post?
What post?
What post?
What
one
post?
You're just, you know, dropping in the
I
on there.
I have
no
clue what you're talking about. Tell us.
Oh, yeah.
Tell us. What post are you talking
about? The edition of my family one.
Yeah. What, the new? I don't know anything about that.
I'm sure, John.
What's this all about?
It's a lesson.
It's a lesson.
A lesson.
A lesson. For people that are reading it?
For those that are just sitting around with nothing better to do than commenting on everyone's status.
It's
almost like, and, you know, if you look at it, and you've been around for a while in the rooms, and you can see how everyone else is paying attention to everyone else's business except their own.
Absolutely.
And how many times have we seen people that are, well, for lack of better words, busybodies?
Mm-hmm.
And they're telling them, you should this and you should that, and, you know, they're always having an opinion. And they forget about where they're standing. And, you know, in recovery, especially early in recovery, we're on very thin ice. And one bad decision can, you know, obviously do just worlds of hurt. And it talks about that in step 6 and 7. Step 6 is about stop doing what doesn't work. Step 7 is about, you know, start doing what does, the defects to assets. And I remember a guy, he's no longer around, but Jimmy L., he said, you know, the bottom line is it's just mind your own business. And one of the biggest things that you know, I can know from my own experience is that I was always in everyone else's stuff because it took the focus off of me. And when I started minding my own business and working on my assets, those things that always took me out started little by slowly dissipate.
Mm-hmm.
and so I really do my best to stay away from other people's stuff.
The other thing is, and to add to that, I was told early on that it's none of my business what other people think of me either.
Or say.
Correct.
Right. They think and say a lot.
Absolutely.
About you, John.
You know what?
Take a number. Get in line.
Get in line, baby. Listen, and here's the good news. You can go to the website, and you can actually talk about me all you want. And you can go to rockersandrecovery.com to do that.
Okay.
So, yeah. Good. Sign up. So in the meantime, I'm just going to...
by the way.
Did you sign up?
I interrupt you. I love doing it, but I didn't...
Rockersandrecovery.com.
I enrolled.
Oh, by the way, I haven't mentioned it yet tonight. Rockers and Recovery is up in operation, and it's now its own social media site. And you can actually go there. You can log in. You can build your own page. And if you're a musician, it's most important for you because you can actually put up your videos. You can put up your music. And if you are, of course, people like Chris D, and, of course, our great and beautiful visitor.
Look at that smile.
She's got a great smile, isn't she? Laura Betts from Hyperbarics RX. She has her information there. Chris now has his information there. And, of course, it's just starting to roll. We have a streamer on there that's running live right now 24/7. We just started our own online radio station. We're going to start syncing that up with the radio station here. So when we're live 18 hours a week here, it will be broadcasting there. But right now we have music playing, and we have over 1,000 hours of past archived Rockers in Recovery and Holistic Lifestyles radio shows.
1,000 hours?
1,000 hours. That's how many we had.
Wow.
Isn't that amazing?
And it's
like a Jerry Seinfeld.
And I remember when it was just 1 hour.
I remember when I was just thinking about this the other day, like the first time you came up. And we had Franz behind the glass, remember?
Franz?
Franz was behind the glass. And then they threw Franz out. They made him go in the mornings. And we brought Chris in. And then Chris was, I think we were on the air for maybe 9 months when Chris got there. So it was about 6 months or 9 months. When did you show up, Chris?
Yeah, it was about after your six-month mark.
Yeah,
it was right there. And then we just got rid of the Griffin's Loft people at Saturday. And that's when I took over.
Yes. We won't even get into that.
No, let's not go down that road.
We won't get into that. But there was a lot. Yeah, it was amazing. But hey, here's the thing. You know, I was sitting at the Thanksgiving broadcast at your house, and one of this kid came up to me out of nowhere, and he's like, "Hey, John, are you John Hollis?" I'm like, "Yeah." He goes, "You know, I just picked up my year, you know, your coin." And I had called you a year ago. We had listened to you in jail all the time. That's scary. I got a captive audience. But we listened to you in jail all the time. And, you know, I called you when I got out, and you hooked me up. And I came over to Chris, and I've been here ever since. I just picked up a year medallion. I want to thank you. It was just amazing to me. Because I was going into that second year, and I was like, you know, I'm saying to myself, you know, I hope this is like helping somebody. You know, I really, you know, you doubt.
What did God do?
I put something in front of me and told me that what he's doing is working, so just stay out of the way and just keep doing it.
Okay, those are his footprints in the sand.
Correct.
Yours, John.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So that's why I know today that my job is to make sure that I continue going in the position that I'm going in and leave the results up to God, because that's the deal. See, again, you did the footwork. I'm sure that there are certain people that you work with at First Step Sober House that you do the footwork, but you leave the results up to God, correct?
Absolutely.
Okay. So in the end, if we're all working in conjunction with positive things and putting positive energy out there, positive energy is going to come back, correct?
Absolutely. We call that paying it forward.
Nice. Would you agree with that?
I would agree with that completely.
In your business, do you do that?
I do it to...
A fault.
I my job is not to make the decision. My job is to give my clients information so that whatever they choose, it's an informed decision.
Mm-hmm.
And unfortunately, sometimes that's telling them something that they don't want to hear. That's telling them that it's going to cost more than somebody else told them.
Mm-hmm.
It might be telling them not to do it at all. I have clients that come to me and they'll say, "Hey, I want to do this hyperbaric thing, and this is how I'm going to do it." And my comment to them is, if that's how you're going to do it, you only have so many discretionary health care dollars for your family. That's not a good value.
Mm-hmm.
I would be shocked if you'd see results. Why don't you put that towards something where you have a much higher chance? And that's not the A answer.
So when you get that phone call, mm-hmm. that says, you know, something, Laura, we want to thank you because you've gotten them.
I have.
We want to thank you for all that you've done for our family and putting it. here, the reality of that for me today is that God has us exactly where we're supposed to be.
Absolutely. And I mentioned, you know, I got into this through scuba diving. The mm-hmm. origins of hyperbaric medicine come from diving. Mm-hmm. I grew up in the gorilla wreck diving community. You know, I'm out on dive boats, and this is, you know, deep, dark, and dangerous, and it was a really kind of extreme point. Mm-hmm. And there I am with all these tanks and all this gear. And if somebody would have told me that, however many years ago, that it was going to take
right?
me that it was going to take me to the point where I'm holding children in my arms and watching their parents cry as they have these positive results from the dive that I just ran for them, I would have never believed it. You know, you don't. I have on my Facebook, you don't choose the things that you believe in; they choose you. And hyperbarics is truly something that chose me. And there are certain things that I'm not willing to compromise. And at the end of the day, I can't help everyone, but the people that I do have the opportunity to work with, I know that I've done the best job for.
It's a beautiful thing, and knowing that you can put your head on the pillow at night and sleep with ease. Because, hey, listen, to be quite frank, I mean, there's a lot of people out there that are predators. I don't care what it is in business, and, you know, I mean, Chris, you know some people in your industry that are predators. That's what they're all about. They're predators. They're not there for an end result. And, you know, the bottom line is that their end result is money. I don't think anybody, yourself included, myself included, I know Laura, well, we all are in this because we love what we're doing. The end result is the bills get paid by the grace of God, thank you. But most importantly, it's about carrying that message. And when you start to carry your message and you bring it into the halls of the justice system, you bring it into the halls of the 12-step fellowships, you're bringing it into the community as a whole. See, this right here, the 12-step music fest, or the Memorial Day weekend concert, is about carrying it to the community.
Yep.
Listen, this is about people in recovery coming to it, but there's a lot of people in that community that has never heard of the 12-step fellowship or an organization that can help, like Brothers Keepers, that's going to be a part of that. All of those different organizations that come out of the First Step Sober House that they never would know is there unless you had a Memorial Day party and a concert like this to be able to let the community know what's going on. Would you agree?
Absolutely.
So do you think it's important to go to the community with this type of thing?
Well, you know, you're reaching out, and it's about awareness.
Mm-hmm.
And you're right. There's a lot of people who don't realize that there are alternatives and or opportunities available for them and their family members or you know, close friends or loved ones right in their own backyard that can help make a profound difference in their life. And, you know, and narrow it down or to the idea of recovery, whatever it is, from alcoholism, drug addiction, substance abuse of some form.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people just don't know. And they don't know what they don't know. And this is an opportunity for them to come to a place and say, great concert, what are you all about?
Mm-hmm.
I have a friend, or I have a son, or I have a father. And, you know, they can come at any time that our office is open, and we'd be more than happy to refer them. We have lots of referrals.
Mm-hmm.
And so it is awareness. And the community is a safer place. You know, especially when they have a harbor, a safe harbor, which they can sail into the weather, whatever storm it is they're riding out.
We started talking tonight about the health aspect of this, okay? And, of course, we're now gradually moving into, from the health aspect of it to, of course, the mental health aspect of it and the emotional care and, of course, the spirituality of it, because all of this works together as a whole. What we talked about with Dr. Gerson from 8 to 8:30, what we've been talking to Laura Betts about from 8:30 until now, and Laura's going to be with us until the end of the show, is all about what we can do to help our recovery. See, nothing's going to replace the 12-step approach. Nothing's going to replace getting a group, getting a sponsor, and doing the things that you need to do to plug in. But what other things can I do to step up my game as I'm going through my recovery? Are there other things that I can do to help out my health, help out my mental health, help out my spirituality along with doing the steps? And there are definitely ways of being able to do it. And from the G&G aspect of it, I think for yourself, you really didn't really realize the addiction component with this until you, like, met John, right?
I was called into G&G after the fact to, as I am often, to...
explain why.
G&G, John did his research and sought out hyperbarics on his own. And for whatever reason, he did not come to my circle. So I was called in after he had made decisions. I was called in to install and provide training on a system that was not a system that I had done a specification for. And it was really just an amazing experience. You know, I walk in and, you know, here I am, and I had no idea that I was at a treatment facility. And it was really when some of those things started to come together. And, of course, since then, I have a fantastic relationship. They're one of the few facilities that I've actually had the privilege of working with that not only has come to me, but actually listen to the recommendations that they've made, and they have a real successful program because of it. And hyperbarics is just one of the things that they do there. And when I'm there and I see the therapy going on, and, you know, of course, oh, you know, the hyperbarics, that Christine calls me the oxygen nerd, which I think is kind of funny. And one of their people will come over and they'll talk to me and they'll go, hey, let me ask you something about this hyperbarics. And, of course, they're doing other types of approaches, they're working the steps, there are other therapies, and I think that one of the things that human nature in general, which is probably part of the reason why they started down the road to addiction in the first place, is you're looking for one thing, you're looking for the magic bullet, the button you push that makes everything go. And hyperbarics is part of the solution. And, you know, I work with clients all the time, and they are miserable people. They are very negative. And I can't help but ask myself, are they sick because they're negative? Or are they negative because they're sick? So that mind-body-spirit link, I see it over and over again, and that the happiest people and the most well people and the most successful people, they're not just doing one thing. And they have that balance. And they have that open to new opportunities.
When you and here's one of the things that I want to, you know, stress tonight, because again, after 32 years of active addiction, when I, you know, started to get sober with my sponsor and started working in the steps, and I started to do all of those things that were asked of me in the 12-step fellowship, John Giordano started to ask me to do some other things like amino acid protocols and omegas and acupuncture and a few other things that I really, my first year, really dove into. And I got to tell you, what it did for me was it reduced the cravings. Now, at that particular point, the oxygen was not involved in that facility down there. But one of the things that I found was that everybody since then that I've talked to, like Dr. Paul Harch and yourself, John Giordano, many other people, they said, you know, they pointed something out to me, and they were like, John, you know, hey, listen, yeah, I think you might have done some brain damage in 32 years. I'm like, yeah, I think. And they're like, well, here's one of the things that oxygen therapy for the last 30 years has been proven to help with is people that have brain damage and people that have done brain injury. So it can help to turn around the brain injury that we do produce by chemicals.
Without question. And there's been a tremendous amount of research, much of it recent. I mean, there's a lot of research that's been on the table. I mean, Dr. Neubauer is a very well-known name in the hyperbaric community. He's passed on. He pioneered some of the original research for hyperbaric for stroke. And, you know, one of the issues with brain injuries is the body requires oxygen to heal. In the case of brain injury, it's very difficult to get the oxygen to that area. And I'll throw in another piece of information. Hyperbarics originated from treating diving injuries, which typically treat at decompression illness, very high pressure. The brain doesn't respond to high-pressure therapy. You know, it's like anything else, hyperbarics, you know, different dosages for different conditions. So,
and we're talking pressure.
And we're talking pressure. And, well, dosage is a relationship between pressure, oxygen supply, and the type and the efficiency of the built-in breathing system. That's a different discussion. But for practical terms, how much the system is delivering. And because diving injuries typically treated so high, there was this lack of information in the hyperbaric community with regard to what to treat. Mm-hmm. And at certain pressures, certain dosages, the brain actually tries to protect itself and it doesn't respond. So a wound care dosage is not the same dosage for brain injury. So there's a lot of information that hasn't been mainstream. And one of the things that has really changed, and if you said, you know, you mentioned it wasn't available when you were working at G&G,
mm-hmm.
one of the reasons for that was access. To put in a diver treatment chamber, huge, expensive, impossible to outfit, no way this therapy could be done in a rehabilitation setting safely or cost effectively.
Mm-hmm.
That's changed. And now the right dosage for this specific condition. And, you know, it's changed a lot.
When you take the, and Chris, I'm going to ask you that question, this question, and then we're going to go to a break. But when you look at all of the, you know, the 12-step approach and everything that we do on a daily basis, there's an alternative here. And do you believe that the alternative approaches can be something that is part of the whole to help a person to heal?
Well, you know, my program has taught me to be open-minded, and that's part of the three sides of the triangles and stuff they talk about, you know, open-mindedness, honesty, and willingness. And, you know, I can only speak to the idea of the 12-step approach and how that changed my life in ways that I still have yet to realize. And that's the thing, you know, much more will be revealed.
Right. Correct.
But at the same time, I've got to be open-minded to the possibilities. I mean, there's no doubt that taking something that has worked so well and enhancing it with alternatives, that the collective effect has got to be a lot better than just taking one thing. And that, you know, and so I would agree that there would have to, you know, that you could incorporate lots of other
modalities
that would obviously, you know, the end result is a much better product than if you just took the one and that was it.
Correct. And I think the longevity of it. I think it's the length of. See, I think the healing process, that, you know, first 2 years of healing process, of healing, you know, like the brain damage and the funk and all of that stuff, that, you know, that the pause and all of the things that we know about today.
And pause is huge.
Yeah.
And that's a great example.
Mm-hmm.
We know hyperbarics helps to minimize pause.
Mm-hmm.
But the idea is, let's just help to keep you working the program.
Correct.
If it helps, even if it helps a little.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and believe me, I'm the first person to say that there isn't one thing that's the right for everyone, and there isn't one thing, and there isn't one combination of things.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it may or may not.
Oh, and believe me, people like us, we search for that magic one thing.
Absolutely.
High and low.
But here's one of the things that I started to find out was that there was a craving and a mental obsession for me, and we're talking about the first step, that mental obsession and that craving was just so overwhelming that what happened was when I got to that, like, 30-day time period, it would get worse and worse and worse. Instead of, like, alcohol where after, you know, 12 days, if you're an alcoholic, 12 days, 15 days, that craving kind of goes away. It comes back every once in a while. But with a crackhead like me, what happened was it literally get junky. What happened, it was after 30 days, 40 days, that band was playing in my head, and it was a 17,000-piece band. When I plugged into the program and I chose in, hey, listen, I got to choose into this thing because that's the foundation of this. But when John came to me and said, listen, I can help to reduce that 1,000-piece band. I can help to reduce those cravings, those overwhelming cravings. I said he was crazy. He said, well, if you think I'm crazy, give it a shot. Give it 90 days and then tell me what you think. And literally, I did it around 45 days, almost 60 days when I started the protocol. 90 days into it, I started to feel the difference. Now, I got to tell you, for my first 9 months, I wanted to use every day. Every day I wanted to use. But at the very end of that 9-month time period, one day I woke up, and by the grace of God, and I truly believe it was from working the steps, but I also know that I made it over the hump because I started working on the brain chemistry. I started working on the spirituality of it, started working on the physical aspects of it, and all in a whole got me to where I'm at today, and I truly, truly believe that. So if you're out there tonight as Chris said. Have an open mind. Understand that I'm not sitting here and nobody's sitting here saying that this is going to replace the 12 steps and it's a silver bullet. There is no silver bullet. You got to go to work. If you want this, you have to choose in and you got to do the work.
We know. There's no cure. There's only a solution. And the word solution is a mixture of things.
Mm-hmm.
And because if there was, I'd have bought it.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Well, there's some guy out of Malibu Beach that says if you read his book that you're cured. I mean,
The Cure.
The Cure. The Cure. That's it, right? Read this.
Read this 190-page volume, and we're not 12 steps, by the way. They will tell you that.
But The Cure for what? And for me.
The clap.
Okay. The cure for drug addiction or alcoholism would not be, hey, I never want to use again. It's not. It's I can use safely. Okay? I can drink sociably.
It's the same scam as The Secret.
Like a civil person. Have you ever seen a sophisticated civil crack smoker?
Have you ever seen, I mean, let's think about it.
You don't come back here tomorrow, John.
You will leave now.
Now.
You red flag from Mama Hotel. You go now. You took all my furniture, turned upside down, ripped the bottom off, looking for crack.
It's a crack house, not a crack mansion.
We're going to go out to a break. When we come back, we'll talk more about the solution. We'll be back right after this message.
Are you ready to explode your business? Then you are ready to take advantage of the massive marketing power of the Holistic Lifestyles Radio Network. Advertise your business, product, or service with one of the most powerful multimedia platforms on the planet. With more than 300,000 online listeners, 30 social media outlets, and a booming 15 hours of live programming on South Florida's 50,000-watt mega giant, AM 1470 WNN, your business will be exposed to hundreds of thousands of active, progressive consumers hungry for your products and services. You'll be featured on blogs, live streams, social media, at live events, and on hundreds of archived podcasts, including Rockers in Recovery, the East Coast Music Scene, Defending Your Money, and dozens more. Plus, primetime national exposure during major festivals from Las Vegas to Boston and the Florida Keys. Get ready to take your business to the next level and jumpstart your branding strategy. Advertise your events, products, and services on the Holistic Lifestyles Radio Network. Call now for special discounted packages, 877-799-8773. That's 877-799-8773. Or visit holisticlifestylesradio.com.
In the fast-paced world we live in, it's hard to find a company that has an impeccable reputation based on professional skill and knowledge, coupled with a strong work ethic, honesty, and integrity. Welcome to the world of Canatelli Builders Incorporated. Specialists in custom residential and commercial construction for three generations, CBI finishes the job as agreed and on time. Browse our website at www.canatellibuilders.com, read the testimonials, then call us at 954-977-2775 and let us add your name to our list of satisfied customers. While at the site, be sure to follow the link for complete information about Chinese drywall and what it may mean to you. Integrity, ethics, honesty, knowledge, performance, service, experience, Canatelli Builders. 954-277-2775. Canatelli Builders, the official contractor for the Florida Panthers.
Hey, this is John Hollis with Rockers in Recovery. We want to thank our sponsor for tonight's show, Hyperbarics RX. You can reach them at hyperbaricsrx.com, or you can reach them at 877-589-9998. Thank you.
The First Step Sober House of Pompano Beach has been part of the 12-step community for 14 years, and they've helped thousands of people to recover from addiction and the issues surrounding addiction. First Step Sober House of Pompano Beach is a sober living community built on the 12-step approach. Male or female, you can learn to be responsible again. Their 3 to 6 month intensive sober living house features a compassionate and structured program, and they work with attorneys and the courts. Call the First Step Sober House of Pompano Beach today, 954-942-7414. That's 954-942-7414. 7414 or go online to firststepsoberhouse.com. Remember, if the elevator to your success is broken, you must take the step. Take the first step today by calling First Step Sober House of Pompano Beach, 954-942-7414, or go online to firststepsoberhouse.com. It's the hottest new addiction recovery mega community on the web, Rockers in Recovery. Music, news, interviews, events, and festivals with an insider's angle to the rock and roll industry. All backed up by artists who are in recovery and support recovery. Featuring dozens of rock legends like former Joan Jett and the Blackhearts lead guitarist Ricky Bird, Richie Supa of Aerosmith, and tons more. It's a worldwide music and media festival at your fingertips. Get inside the rock and roll recovery scene with a click of your mouse. Click rockersinrecovery.com. That's rockersinrecovery.com.
Thinking that there weren't any decent men left in the world.
There isn't.
I sent her a mushy one, too. I want to be home holding you.
Aww.
None of that, buddy.
Huh?
None of that.
Yeah. He'll be home here momentarily.
You know what this weekend is?
What is it?
This is Mother's Day weekend coming up.
Well, it's not this weekend. Next
coming
weekend.
Up.
Yeah.
Well, the weekend's over. This is like Sunday night.
And this is like my Saturday.
It is.
Yeah, or Monday. Something like
definitely
that.
Definitely need to be in that chamber, buddy.
I'm thinking about
we
it.
We need to saturate him with oxygen.
Anytime, baby. Anytime.
Really?
I just would be worried about what would happen, though. You know?
I might grow hair.
I'm not so sure about the hair, but, you know, you might even get around. I didn't mean it like
that. Wow. What's that, man? Wait a minute, what's that? Oh. He'll be home in a little while, honey. He'll be home, baby. You just hang tight, okay? He's leaving any minute. The way that we work around here is just amazing. Memorial Day weekend free concert, May 28, 2011, 1:30 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Ricky Bird, guitar, singer, songwriter of the New York City Hit Squad and formerly of Joan Jett and the Blackhearts and Roger Daltrey and Ian Hunter and lots of other folks. And Chasm Sultan, bassist, singer, songwriter of Todd Rundgren, Utopia, Mick Jagger, and Celine Dion. Along with, of course, a full band behind them will be playing the concert at the First Step Sober House, along with Scheduled to Play, Keep Coming Back, Johnny B and the Road Dogs, Rhetoric, and Thrown Alive, who is coming in from Tampa. And we're looking forward to having this event, again, May 28, 2011. It's located at the First Step Sober House, 450 Southwest 2nd Street, Pompano Beach, Florida. You can give them a call at 954-942-7414. Check them out also by going to firststepsoberhouse.net. And you can check all of that out right there on the website. You can check everything out at rockersinrecovery.com or holisticlifestylesradio.com. Join us on Facebook at Rockers in Recovery. Enjoy the concert for free and also enjoy the free food.
Free food.
Free food all day long.
Yeah.
Hot dog after hot dog after hot dog.
Three outhouses.
Wow. Wow.
I'll be at the concert, by the way.
Yes. Yes, you're gonna put on a big hair. We're gonna have Laura Betts dressed up like an 80s chick.
Right big up, hair.
Big hair. Awesome. Big hair.
I remember the days.
Remember them days? I remember when I had hair. It was lovely. I can have big hair, half a hair right now. My forehead turned into an 8-head.
Does this mean I can finally live out my dream and get my fro?
Your fro. Yeah. Nice. Right. Can you imagine Chris with a fro? It'd be pretty funny.
I'm talking like, you know, big old Huey Freeman from the Boondocks type pro, too.
Nice. Nice. You know something? My girlfriend's son has one of those. He has one of these big Africans. So it's pretty funny. I'll have to get that from him. I'll come out dressed like Jimi Hendrix, introduce the band. It'll be fun. So on a much less of a funny note,
More serious note?
No, less of a funny note.
Okay.
Because this lady was really kind of a funny lady, but we're not going to talk about funniness on this because Phoebe Snow passed away and she was 60 years old. And what this lady brought to the rock and roll community was just amazing. 1975, she had a hit called The Poetry Man. She is from Edison. She was originally from Edison, New Jersey, and, of course, she had a brain hemorrhage that she suffered in January of 2010 and just passed away from, of course, everything that came out of that brain hemorrhage, talking about the brain hemorrhage end of this. And what some of the things that took place through that time frame was cancer. They found out that she did have brain cancer, and she did have situations that were occurring physically with her that kept her from great, great events. There were several events that she was scheduled to play. One was with Levon Helm and was not able to make that. And Levon Helm actually got on stage and was in tears, basically, that Phoebe Snow was not going to be with him. Great voice, great blues lady, and most importantly, will be missed by a lot of people. And we thank our friend Christine Ullman from the Saturday Night Live band for making us aware of this last week and telling us about all that she had done for the rock and roll industry for many years. Christine Ullman has written a blog on Phoebe Snow, and we are going to be posting that tomorrow on rockersandrecovery.com and also on the Holistic Lifestyles Radio Network, of course, a blog page. And we'd like you to take a look at it and read it. And, Christine, we thank you for giving us the insight and the importance of this lady in the rock and roll industry. Thank you so much. And, Laura, we're going to talk about your Hyperbarics RX right now. And I want you to just take the next 5 minutes and condense why you decided that you wanted to be the – of course, oxygen lady that you are, the oxygen geek.
Oxygen nerd.
Oxygen nerd.
Not to be specific.
Okay.
So I truly love what I do. And I mentioned a little earlier on that I didn't quite realize when I started doing this what, you know, it kind of took on a life of its own.
Mm-hmm.
And we started working with portable chambers on deep expeditions, kind of out in the middle of nowhere, your hours, days from the nearest hyperbaric chamber, and in the case of a diving injury, that can make the difference between a bad day and paralyzed for the rest of your life, or worse. So it's a pretty serious thing. So this whole thing kind of started, and I had been teaching pathophysiology of oxygen, which is, you know, kind of what happens when you go in a chamber, through some of the optimal breathing gas technology programs that we've been working with over the last 20 years, breathing mixtures other than air for scuba diving, and that whole extended range profile, and being able to apply that information. I mean, taking somebody scuba diving and watching their eyes when they see, you know, something underneath the water that they find beautiful the first time is really exciting. You know, seeing them when they come up from their first dive and they go, wow, that was great. That's neat.
Yeah, the expression on somebody's face is just incredible.
It's nothing in comparison to this. Mm. And when I started using the technical knowledge that I had to install systems, when I started doing training for facilities on how to operate the equipment, when I started working with families, I really had no idea how rewarding and how wonderful was going to be.
The correlation of the two really didn't even make sense to you at that point.
It didn't happen. How some of it started was this information, kind of, the diving community really, and hyperbarics in general, a lot of this information is very closed, and if you're not kind of in the group, you don't really have access to the information, and if you don't know somebody, you wouldn't have it. So here I am growing up in something, doing it, you know, day to day, there are things that are commonplace, and this is whatever all the guys did, what we all talked about. This is the idea of how oxygen was beneficial, and if you had a bad day. I mean, we were the oxygen bar concept. There was a running joke 20 years ago. You know, divers notoriously drink a lot, by the way. I'm not one of them. Just throwing that out there. So it's really changed, and I was called out to install a system at home, and one of the services that we offer, you know, yes, hyperbarics, the systems are made to be easy to use, some of them. You know, the clinic systems are a little bit more complicated, but in some of the systems are very simple. But that's no substitute for having a certified technician. Stand there, set it up, hold your hand.
Well, and that brings up a point that these cameras are being used by sports figures across the country that are putting them in their homes because when you get done a game on Sunday night, you're playing professional football, you get done your game on Sunday night, your actual repair time for all of your muscles is usually 72 hours.
Right,
correct?
Afterwards. And one of the other pieces of the equation that's missed a lot, you know, if you say, well, hyperbaric sounds so great, how come everybody isn't doing it? Mm. Well, when we talk about healing the brain, when we talk about, you know, the person who was in a motor vehicle accident and is in a vegetative state, and then you see the video where they're standing up, walking, and talking, that's 200, 300, 400 dives later. How does a family with multiple children administer hyperbarics and have quality of life? How do you go back and forth? So one of the reasons why an athlete or why someone might choose to have one of these systems is as much the access, the schedule of having to do this therapy every day. How does it happen?
Hmm.
So,
well,
you know,
and there's a big difference between $75 or $100 bucks per session and just, you know, getting one and putting in your home.
Oh, absolutely. And keep in mind, some facilities charge, the average price in the country right now is $350 a session.
Wow.
And some facilities actually bill out over $1,000. Now, these are Medicare reimbursable conditions, and they wouldn't even take someone for something that they couldn't bill an insurance company for. But it's a huge amount of money here. So there is the, you know, part of making the decision about what's best for you and your family or your clinic or where the application is has to deal with, okay, well, what would it cost for X? How many would we need? And, you know, and then you can really at least make some informed choices about where you'd like to spend your money, if you'd like to spend your money. You know, so that's kind of how that comes together also.
The athletic end of this, and I want to go back to this for a minute because I think it's important for people to be aware that, you know, I was just reading an article about Daryl Strawberry.
Mm-hmm.
And Daryl Strawberry, who is very much into the autism awareness and has his own autism program that he works with, and he's basically announced that he's looking at the oxygen aspect of it, which is pretty amazing. When you start to see the sports figures, knowing that it repairs the body and the damage that's being done while they're out there playing professional sports, is now turning around saying, well, wait a minute, if it's working with this,
right. It's
a good possibility we might be able to work with this from what you found in your
history. Here's another interesting piece. Terry Bradshaw just did an article. It was on Fox News. I mean, it's a big article where he talks about the issues that he's dealing with from the concussions that he experienced being a pro football player. And there's a lot of professional athletes. And, you know, the pro athletic community, when your career is over, they don't really care about what happens to you, unfortunately. And a lot of professional football players, they'll talk about how they kind of were, you know, thrown to the side. And one of the things that hyperbarics has the potential of doing is not just performance enhancing. It has the potential to prevent some of these things from happening or, if anything, prevent the severity of it. And a lot of information there. So there's an aspect there. They in the post-traumatic stress disorder studies where they found out that soldiers, the exposure to the improvised explosive devices was actually creating a brain injury, and they directly linked this brain injury to the post-traumatic stress. So if you treat with hyperbarics very close to proximity of injury, they don't get the tissue death that causes these severe symptoms down the road.
Being a medical disease, because alcoholism is a medical disease, and if it's treated as a medical disease, the treatment of it, of course, is the 12-step approach, and of course, those are the maintaining of your program. But at the same time, medical aspect of this, they used to treat with hydrotherapy. They used to treat with so many different things back in the day. Now it's grown into so many other things. So what, at this point, would you say to somebody that's in their first 30 days, other than we know you need to be involved and go into meetings and you need to have a sponsor and you need to start working your steps, what are some of the things that they could start to do holistically to help them?
if they have an opportunity to work with a facility that supports the 12 steps as well as offering an integrated approach, that is a fantastic option for them right then and there. And very often there's quite a few facilities now that actually have chambers, and getting in there and doing a few dives as a part of their detox program can actually be beneficial. I mean, there's clinical evidence, there's conclusive studies that using hyperbarics as a detox approach, so we're talking about early onset now, you just got clean, so now we've rid the body of the actual chemical. Now we're dealing with the psychological addiction, which is very, very strong, and I don't have a lot of experience with this, but I would think that the 12-step provides support better than anything else for that aspect.
Absolutely.
There. So, you know, using the hyperbarics to mitigate the physical, let's fix what we can fix, and then let's support the mind, let's support the spirit. But let's not have something physical getting in the way of being able to perhaps hear the message that they need.
Good stuff. And, of course, for bets, can be found at hyperbaricsrx.com. And she is, of course, one of our sponsors of the show. And we want to thank you for your sponsorship. And, of course, our other sponsor from the First Step Sober House, Chris has been sponsoring us since where it all began. And we want to thank you for doing that. And
You're welcome.
All of the things that you make happen with us and you're a part of. In closing, on the 12-step end of this, if you have somebody that's listening tonight, just getting out of detox, just, you know, maybe they're on the couch and, you know, they got the paycheck on Friday, they've run out of money.
Too much month at the end of the month.
Absolutely. They're sitting there and they're busted, broke, busted, and disgusted, and the wife's pissed off, the dog can't stand them, everybody's mad. What would you say to somebody in that situation?
You out of gas, dude. No. It's about not giving up. It really is. And, I've been in that place of despair or incomprehensible demoralization where everything that I've tried has failed utterly because of certain things that are paramount in my life, and that was that obsession to use. And I can't remember how many times that on Friday I get paid and Saturday night I'm already broke. You know, and making excuses, and everyone hates me. No one wants me around. And I finally got to a place of exhaustion, you know, and thank God I did, where I reached out for help. And it sounded like I don't know what to do. It wasn't, I got this, like, you know, but I just don't know what to do. And I need help. And when the help arrives, though, we have to go after it unconditionally. With no holds barred. I see so many people over the years that put stipulations on how the help is going to come. I'll do this, but I must have, and in order to, you know, negotiating their rescue party.
Mm-hmm.
You're in a sinking ship, and here comes the boat to pick you up, and you're trying to negotiate with the guy. Let me go back and get this, that, and that. No, dude, get off, okay? Because you're going to go down with the ship. But, okay, see ya. You know, let me move on to someone else who's really got their hand out. I've been listening very carefully to what's been said here, and it's like free your mind and the rest will follow. I mean, you know, we need to be able to free ourselves emotionally and physically in order to have the obsession removed, and that takes time. This is not an overnight thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's a process, and that's why we call it the recovery process. It's constantly turning out new results.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean look at you, John. I mean, you were just tore up from the floor up person. I remember last time I saw you when you were out there, and on the other side of it, you have slowly transformed your life on all levels, and that's the beauty of and uniqueness of the recovery process and what it can do for people's lives and the people around them, because I think that's something that we touch on a lot when it comes to recovery. I hear the same thing when you're talking about the therapy that you put on, how the family around the individual who's getting this treatment gets a wellness too.
out of them. And that's just the gratitude and the gift that they get when they have a loved one that has been changed.
I really am glad that I get to watch all of the people that come through here and have watched them come through here over the years. And most importantly, I've also been able to be a part of the First Step Sober House in one form or another for many years and have watched the change happen at the First Step Sober House and the growth that has taken place and the people that have been helped. In memory of Richard, who you know, helped thousands upon thousands of people.
Absolutely.
And literally, you know, that torch has been carried on by Chris. And, you know, and of course yourself, you know, you put your life, you know, and your dedication to your business and to helping families and to help the commitment level of getting healthier is there with you. So. This is what the community is all about. Here, and I don't care where you're at, recovery is universal. Recovery from addiction is universal. It doesn't matter where you're sitting right now. You can go to anywhere at any time and go to a 12-step meeting. Now, I'm going to go out and with closing right now on one particular thing that was pretty interesting. I was in South Jersey, and I ended up hitting two meetings in South Jersey. I left South Jersey. I went up to the Poughkeepsie area. I was in Poughkeepsie, and I hit meetings the whole time I was in Poughkeepsie. And when I was out in Chicago this past year for the Clapton Crossroads Guitar Festival, I'm in Chicago. What do? I go to the festival, and I go to meetings. It doesn't matter where I'm at. It was in Boston. I went to meetings in Boston. There are meetings everywhere, man. You can go to a 12-step meeting anywhere on the face of the earth now.
Isn't that cool?
It's amazing. And so there's no excuse. If you're listening to us tonight and you're anywhere in this country or you're in Canada or England or wherever you're listening to us on the streamer, I can tell you that if you ask, you will find a 12-step meeting. And all you need to do is ask. And you can send an email to john@rockersinrecovery.com, and I would be glad to research that, or anybody would be glad to research it for you. That's a part of our staff, and we would definitely get that information back to you. You can also go to, of course, any of the A's. They got the NA, AA, and OA, and all of that stuff that are all part of the 12-step process, and you can check that right on, you know, online. Just put in 12-step organizations into your search engine, and all of them come up.
Pages.
And get in where you fit in.
Mm-hmm.
And in the meantime, we're going to thank you tonight for tuning in with us at Rockers in Recovery. We're going to listen to Will Grayson's Thursday night show on, of course, the 10 o'clock hour, and then the Monty Man from 11 to 12. So we will be back, of course, tomorrow, 2 o'clock live. We're looking forward to another beautiful day tomorrow here in South Florida. We're out.
Yes, she's a diva. She'll try to please you. She'll love and leave you. Yes, she's a diva. Yes, she's the diva. The diva of love.
The preceding program is a Rockers in Recovery radio production. Rights to this program are the sole rights of Rockers in Recovery Radio, Incorporated. Rebroadcast of this program in any form without express written consent is prohibited.
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
It's a honest new addiction.
In the fast-paced world we live in, it's hard to find a company that has an impeccable reputation based on professional skill and knowledge, coupled with a strong work ethic, honesty, and integrity. Welcome to the world of Canatelli Builders Incorporated. Specialists in custom residential and commercial construction for three generations, CBI finishes the job as agreed and on time. Browse our website at www.canatellibuilders.com, read the testimonials, then call us at 954-977-2775 and let us add your name to our list of satisfied customers. While at the site, be sure to follow the link for complete information about Chinese drywall and what it may mean to you. Integrity, ethics, honesty, knowledge, performance, service, experience, Canatelli Builders. 954-277-2775. Canatelli Builders, the official contractor for the Florida Panthers.
Attention, the 4th Annual 12-Step Music Fest is coming November 3rd through the 6th in Sugarloaf Key, Florida.
4 days of music and fun with 12 musical acts along with the Rockers in Recovery Supergroup featuring Ricky Bird, guitarist formerly of Joan Jett and the Blackhearts, Liberty DeVito, formerly of Billy Joel, Woody Geisman of the Del Fuegos, Kason Sultan of Todd Rundgren and Utopia, Christine Ullman of the Saturday Night Live Band, and four more to be announced by September. Find out more about this sober Woodstock in Sugarloaf Key by joining rockersinrecovery.com or by calling 877-799-8773. Silence calms the mind and rejuvenates the body. God Pillow has been inspiring daily devotions for over 11 years. God Pillows are custom made with love and intention. We encourage you to become part of our community. Come visit God Pillow on the World Wide Web at godpillow.com.
Judy was boring.
Hello.
Then Judy discovered Chumbacasino.com.
It's my little escape.
Now Judy's the life of the party.
Oh, baby, mama's bringing home the bacon.
Whoa, take it easy, Judy. The Chumba life is for everybody. So go to Chumbacasino.com and play over 100 casino-style games. Join today and play for free for your chance to redeem some serious prizes. Chumbacasino.com. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus terms and conditions apply. See website for details.